Of the many Deftones fans and music fans in general, one of the few things that they had to look forward to in 2020 was the promise of new music from the group. Our hopes were rewarded with Ohms, Deftones' 9th studio album. Hearing Chino's voice and the rest of the band playing makes a small part of 2020 somehow bearable.
Deftones are one of the bands where I've never been able to hold back my bias, so disclaimer, this album review is coming from a longtime fan. However, I'm aware not every Deftones fan loves everything the band has done. So I wanted to go into Ohms with as much of a blank slate as possible, just wanting new music and seeing what they could do.
Ohms runs 10 tracks across roughly 46 minutes and features the return of Terry Date producing. The process of writing the album was unique in that guitarist Stephen Carpenter had much more involvement with writing the album and incorporated a 9-string guitar in the recording. This is huge for the fans of Deftones' heavier style, as Carpenter really is underrated with what he can do with an axe. On top of that, Ohms has a ton of elements going on at the same time, from alt metal to shoegaze to glorified noise rock. In an interview with Kerrang, Chino said, "We don't need to make a record just for the sake of making a record. We make them because this is what we like to do. We like to hang out. We like to make noise. And we like to make some songs out of that noise." This is a golden description of what Deftones creates with music. So much of it is atypical of format and any standard that it's hard to describe the band's style to people who don't know it. Deftones like to make songs out of noise, and Ohms is proof of that.
I went into Ohms wanting a bit of variety and heavy and soft because Deftones have been able to do both extremely well over the decades, whether that's on distinctly different tracks or all of it transitioning in together on the same song. I wanted to hear that variety of both styles in some form.
The title track was the first new Deftones we received in years, and it closes out the album with a big note. According to Chino, the title track is a good base of how the entire album sounds, and I agree with that. The riff is great from Steven, and Chino's cleans and unclean sound strong. It's not too loud at any point, and the repeated guitar notes in the last minute from the opening of the song is a clever way to wrap up the album. It's a solid track. Genesis was the other song to come before the album, and it's the album opener. This is where my anticipation of the album peaked. I loved this song. Chino's delivery from anger to soothing is amplified in the mixing, and the haunting rhythm of the song is amazing. I love the short buildups, and this song is dripping with an intimidating atmosphere while still having plenty of serene moments. Along with a short bridge from Steven, everyone shines on this song.
Genesis is one of my favorite songs on the album, and by far my favorite of the two singles. It's the low tones in the guitar riff and bass, along with the changing in vocals from Chino, as it all just melts together perfectly. These are strong opening and closing tracks for an album, and they definitely serve their purposes well on Ohms.
Ceremony has some strong instrumental work. The flow and mood of this song is wonderful, and Ceremony is fluid and has a thick groove. The line of "It's all an illusion" with the guitar strumming along reminds me why I love Deftones so much. There are memes about how Deftones' music is sexual while having nothing to do with sex. Yeah, Ceremony will be someone's aphrodisiac after hearing it. Urantia starts heavier with some thick riffs and then changes gears to a smooth vocal performance. The harmonic guitars are great and the thick riffs kick back in while Chino is still singing and doesn't clash. The connecting bridge halfway through is a bit off-putting and seemingly out of nowhere, but the mood continues as soon as it's over. Error is a bit heavier in the music with the bass from Sergio working with the guitars, and Chino sounds like he's almost ready to cut loose and scream his head off, but doesn't quite do it. There's a slight speed change that's slick, and while the track is almost 5 minutes, it goes by quickly. Error has a fantastic sound in it. The Spell of Mathematics has a vibe much like the title track, with Chino getting loud on the steady riff that breaks down to a slower speed. It's the longest song on the album, and a decent song if not something that wasn't already similar sounding on Ohms. Think of it more as a slower version of the title track, but more ambient and almost ethereal. It's the second half of the track that steals the show, though. Pompeii is where Chino becomes a bit more haunting with his vocals, and you hear the rhythm behind him amplify that feeling. His soothing voice at parts builds up the big moments when he becomes fierce. The louder notes from Chino don't sound as clear as others, but Chino definitely still sells everything, and the electronic atmosphere to close out the last minute feeding into the next track feels unique. This Link is Dead, which is not about website connections oddly enough, has the anger and frustration being expelled that when Deftones try to make, they can really hit home. The sections of the guitar and percussion breaking things down feels enormous warmest near the end, and this is another track that goes by very fast. Radiant City sounds quick and punchy from the opening seconds. Even with Chino breathing out the words, he quickly picks up the pace and tone. This is a Deftones track that embodies so many emotions in one listen. It's invigorating, and there is a feeling of action moving forward and wanting to not do it alone. I like it. And finally, Headless has a quiet, significant introduction before leading into the song, and Chino sounds great here. The verses almost sound sinister with the man's performance. There is a hard riff which feels almost disjointed from the chorus, but that chorus soars when it finally arrives. It does feel a bit long for what it's trying to make, but it still works, as does the vast majority of this album.
Going in, I tried my best not to compare Ohms to past albums and listen to it independently. After several listens, I realized that Ohms really sounds like a Deftones album in that there is so much going on, even in the quiet moments. The noise they made to create music on top of leads to big moments. It's hard to say which song stands out the most on Ohms, but it's easy to say that the album feels complete and stands out in a good way, both in the current music scene and in Deftones' discography.
Overall, Ohms is a solid reminder of why Deftones are still a prominent name in rock and metal. Stephen Carpenter's contribution with the heavier moments are strong while not overpowering, and Chino still sounds hypnotizing in the best way possible. Terry Date helped bring back the magic. The results are radiant, and Ohms add to a lifestyle that never gets old. What did you think of Ohms? Leave a comment and let everyone know. Big thanks to my patrons and a special thanks to Brandon Barenfeld, Chris Doman, McKenna White, and Dom Smith. You can help support the channel and have a say in upcoming videos by supporting Rocked On Patreon. Please click the link in the video description for more info. Please subscribe and ring the bell to get notified on upcoming videos. You can check out my concert photography on Instagram, and you can keep up to date with Rocked on Facebook and Twitter.